problem. Yeah, is that
yeah,
you
yeah, yeah, yeah.
That
yeah.
is my problem. Yeah. My
okay.
question is
appropriate according to who? Yeah, 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 yeah. Go
this
ahead.
Is
yeah.
from the eyes
no,
of
thank
an
you
atheist.
For being out here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
This
yeah.
is from the eyes of an atheist.
Yeah.
Even if it is
yeah.
a religious thing and like
yeah.
abortion is wrong for Christians, but then again, for you.
I appreciate y'all being
here. Moment in America yeah. where like you have to question what freedom really means. If a woman wants to get an abortion, and I'm not saying that it's okay, but like it's their decision. It's their child. Maybe they're going under a lot of things where like adoption just isn't an option for them.
Okay.
Or like they were already told that the baby was gonna be stillborn, so why not just save it the misery of like being born dead anyway?
It's less bad if they're raped.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. It's better if like one. I
well,
so appreciate
it.
And I will answer rape too. Yeah,
what
absolutely.
If
yeah.
Rape?
Yeah,
and
yeah,
like
yeah,
the guy
yeah,
that
yeah.
raped them gave
yeah.
them that child. Why would they want to keep a child where they're?
Okay, there's a lot. There's a lot there. Can I respond? Can I respond to that? And then we can elaborate. First of all. So the laws of logic would say that we apply that logic across the board. Okay, so what we're doing is we're begging the question about the nature of the unborn. Because we wouldn't say that a mother who's in a hard situation could like take a gun and like blow their two-year-old child. We would say that was 100%.
Treat the two-year-old as if an unborn fetus and two-year-old are the same.
That is the issue. That is the issue.
I agree. We're
saying that the only difference between the fetus
and then one.
Hold on now.
Well, not objectively, but is it?
I'm trying to answer the whole question. One second. Yeah, it's better that way. So, what we're saying, the only difference between you as a embryo and that two-year-old is size, level of development, environment, and degree of dependency. So, do we kill human beings because of their size?
In American history, there have been.
Yeah, and that's totally wrong. But we need an out. Yeah, that's totally wrong. Yeah, and I'm going to get into that. Hold on, we're almost to the rape thing. Almost. And
I have another question.
Okay, can I finish answering the... So she put a lot on the table, and I'm so appreciating y'all being out here. Like, if I sound like Annabelle, I'm just from New York, you know what I mean? Like, I love y'all, and the reason I'm out here is because I love y'all, all right? And this is true. And we're out here bringing it into conflict with the evil that's inculcated in our culture. That's why we're out here. So size, level of development. Do we kill some... Is my two-year-old less developed than my 14-year-old? Okay, can I kill her?
That, in today's society, no, that's still murder.
Okay, yeah, that would be murder. No. So, but if society gets to decide what murder is, okay, then all it takes is a majority vote to go back to the 1800s and say, hey, that was right.
Yeah, but within the 1800s, it was still technically illegal to be getting an abortion.
No, but we're talking about slavery now. You see what I'm saying? So we
that's
we
another
yeah
question.
Yeah yeah no and I'm gonna go into that, but hold on, we're two pieces in here. Size, level of development. We don't kill babies. We said we wanted evidence that the unborn is actually human. So size, level of development, right? Do we kill somebody because they're less developed or more developed? No. Environment, location. Is somebody worth more as a human being based on their location? Like, am I worth more in the high school than out here? Am I worth more speaking at a podium? Like, I speak across the nation. Am I worth more speaking at a podium than I am speaking to you right here? Hold on, no. That we're talking about the identity of the unborn here. We're not addressing the slavery issue, which
how
we will say, yeah, and it does, and it
like,
there's yeah, and I am gonna I'm gonna show you the parallel. The parallel is actually okay,
the
and
beating a black
because blacks are humans, right?
Yeah, obviously.
And, yeah, obviously, right? And we're saying that the unborn are humans too.
But you're
obviously.
Also saying,
when they're
also saying that
raping
yeah.
cotton to the
whole
yeah.
when they're raped, when they're beaten, when they were treated like they were subhuman.
But does this because what? Wait a second here. Because how are you, is it okay for me to take a baby and slam his head against the ground?
But the baby hasn't been born yet. It's just.
It's an egg.
Okay.
It's
wait, so, but see, we just addressed that argument. But from the point of fertilization, when we have a zygote, the point of fertilization, an embryo, all we have is size, level of development, environment, degree of dependency. It is self-directed. Hold on.
You're killing a two-year-old baby is
yeah.
equal to a zygote?
Absolutely. From the embryonic phase.
A zygote
yeah.
is compared
yeah.
to the beating yeah. of my ancestors. That's
human beings, all human. All human beings.
Human
all
beings
humans are equal.
Then,
all humans are equal.
I mean, is it? Are you killing?
What?
Are you, is it murder? To
all humans. All humans.
We can't compare
all
slavery
humans.
To.
Why is slavery wrong?
Because they treated
it was
white people.
It was a racist.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Based on whose law?
Then how would that compare to the whole?
Okay, the government's law, right? The government's law. Now, the government's law was wrong, correct? All right, and it ought to be disobeyed, correct? Okay, that's what we're saying. That is the parallel. We're saying it's not a choice. We're saying that reproduction has, hold on now. We're saying reproduction has already taken place.
But you're also saying that it's similar to the Holocaust where it was mass genocide.
Oh, this is, we have 60 million babies. So, I mean, look at these pictures. We have 60 million babies.
From Hitler killed all those people because they were Jewish, because they weren't German.
Yeah.
People aren't killing babies.
And homosexuals and lower desires,
but
desirables and things like that.
They didn't kill them because of that.
Okay.
The Jewish have been going through so many struggles throughout the entirety of history.
Yeah.
They've been enslaved, attacked, killed, murdered off, blamed for all the problems. How would that compare to a woman deciding that a baby in her life is not the best option?
Well, yeah, that's fine. There's options that she can have, but one of them isn't murdering the baby.
You know the trauma. Like, well, tell you, it's murder. You know the trauma of that?
Well, we just went over that, though. Like, I said that... Hold on. Because we... yes. But absolutely. Thank you. You've been very respectful. Here's the thing, okay? What we're saying is that from the earliest stages, the human being has its own metabolism. That's how scientists determine life, right? I'm supposed to be the unscientific Christian religious zealot, right? Metabolism. Yeah. Okay, yeah. So ad hominem attacks. There you go. There you go. Good job. So it's to the man. Yeah. So self-directed, it's not part of the mother's body. The egg, as you would put it, that's fertilized by the sperm, is its own. What species is the fertilized egg? Is it a goat?
Cells.
No. Yeah, I'm not. So are you. Your cells too.
So is it murder if we cut ourselves and the cell blossoms?
No, but
I draw the line for abortion. Just like a
so it's a level of development.
When
would it be okay to? When is it? When does that baby magically earn the protection? When it actually comes out of the?
No,
when it starts to develop okay. The body parts that make it into a human being.
Do you understand what a just? Okay,
decide that it is
that's
okay
called a just so argument. Development of body parts doesn't make you a human being. If you cut my arm off, am I less human?
But you're already developed. You're outside of that.
You're saying body parts, the development of body parts, or consciousness, for example. We're saying that
all the comparisons that you're making, like slavery, like racism, like Holocaust, that's nothing compared to
all you're doing is saying that, though.
It's disrespectful because there's no
correlation. No, it's actually the utmost form of respect. It's saying that an unjust law is no law at all.
Well, why are you comparing, like, the mistreatment of my people, my ancestors, the slavery, like, when they were enslaved?
Okay.
How does that compare?
Do you understand who gets the most abortions? Do you know that?
If
do you know?
Women get abortions,
no, but do you know? Do you know where?
Babies because they want to kill it. They have a reason behind.
Yeah, but do you hold on now? Do you know that the founder of Planned Parenthood, Margaret Sanger, actually sought to exterminate blacks? Do you know that?
Yeah, I know that. And then that doesn't mean that it's going.
And do you know that there was
that ideology? There's going to be new people. That's like me saying that since you like. Say you're a Republican, I'm gonna blame you for
I'm not, by the way. Yeah.
If I were to say that's like kind of on the same level, but Planned Parenthood isn't just for abortion, it's for people who have STIs, STDs, trying to help those people.
Yeah, and Auschwitz cooked a good soup. And Auschwitz cooked the good soup. We are standing. You know that there was more babies murdered in New York in 2012 than were actually born there. And the imagine if you took it outside of abortion to any other category. We have the founder of an organization. Absolutely, sir. We have the founder of an organization saying, I want to eradicate the black race. Says that. And Hispanics. Says that. And then we have this targeting in the minority communities through abortion. 80% of abortion mills. We're standing up. We're saying no. We're saying
it's
no
not,
to racism.
It's not the problem that you're standing up. It's the problem that you're doing this in front of a high school full of children.
And there's not even any teen pregnancy here.
By the numbers, 75%. 75% of high school kids, and I'm included.
Whoa, hold on. Think somebody will be popping babies in Frisco?
Hey, I don't know. Hey, first of all, and I don't mean to yell, by the way. Hold on. Let me get your question. Yeah.
So my question is, have you yourself ever been through rape?
No.
No, I have actually.
I don't know. I was a bad person back in the day, and I was I'm not the good person.
Nice discussion.
Yeah.
So you've never.
thank you very much for sharing. I really appreciate you. You're really sharp, okay? I want you to think about some of this stuff a little more. Just what the state tells you and what liberalism just kind of tells you.
Like, I know
this ain't
experience, like, white liberals, they don't do much for my people to begin with.
Yeah, they don't. And I'm out here, I'm saying
when it comes to abortion, it's a woman's, in the end, it's a woman's choice.
It's a woman's choice to murder her baby.
No, but see,
it's not, it doesn't become a baby.
But if somebody,
you know that
they're gonna be stuck with the trauma. And imagine, like, if that happened to me, I wouldn't be able to. And my mom had to get an abortion. She was homeless. She had nowhere to go. She couldn't take care of that baby. If she were to have it, where was she supposed to take it?
Okay.
She was a black girl that was homeless and was living in a shelter. How was she?
Okay.
How?
Okay. How? There, you can give it up for adoption. Give the baby up for adoption.
But she couldn't. She was homeless. System. She had nowhere to go.
All right. It's still. So what you?
She could have gone to the hospital. They would have given her free in America, anywhere, any state.
She could not.
Here.